And on the far side of the ring, Muhammad Ali. Norton will be wearing blue trunks, or if you're in black and white, the darker trunks. Muhammad Ali, resplendent in white. Now, ladies and gentlemen, from mid-ring, Jeff Temkin, ring announcer, with the introductions.
Fabulous Forum in Inglewood, California. These bouts are sanctioned under the California State Athletic Commission, the Honorable Gordon Del Faro, President. Your officials for tonight, timekeeper and counting at the knockdowns, Cliff Gaz. Your ringside physicians, Dr. Jack Useem, assisted by Dr. Ray Paris. Judging at ringside, John Thomas and George Latka. Referee for the main event will be Dick Young. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your main event of the evening. 12 rounds or less for the North American heavyweight title. On my right, from San Diego, California, wearing the blue trunks with the white stripe, weighing in tonight at 205 pounds, the number one ranking heavyweight in all the world, Kenny Norton. And on my left, from Louisville, Kentucky, weighing in tonight, 212 pounds, wearing the white trunks with the black stripe, the former heavyweight champion of the world, Muhammad Ali.
All right. Fellas, you're going 12 rounds in here for the North American Heavyweight Championship. I expect a good, clean, hard fight all the way. When you go to the body, keep those punches up. I don't want any low blows. I want any kidney punches or rabbit punches.
Very little staring by Ali.
And hit with the free hand. I'll give you the opportunity to work out of every clinch. But whatever you're doing, when I say break, you stop it and you step back, both of you. Break ground. But protect yourselves when you do. You bet? I will. Bit of a knockdown. The man down must take eight. The man on his feet will go to the farthest corner remaining. Now, is there any questions? Okay.
We'd like to welcome all the broadcasters from the many, many foreign countries that are televising and radioing this fight tonight, particularly to Lucian Shen, the great matchmaker from Jamaica, who is here, hopeful of getting Ali, if he wins, to come down to Jamaica and fight. Also like to say happy birthday to President Marcos of the Philippines. Round one of a schedule 12. Between them in 73 fights, there's only been three losses. One loss by Norton, two by Muhammad Ali, who stings him with a left. And Ali definitely up on the toes, Bud.
He said he'd be dancing.
Look at Kenny Norton smile at him.
Note the stiff right hand, right leg of Kenny Norton.
Norton is a stiff arm fighter, a stand-up fighter. He is not fast. And when he bores in, he becomes a pretty good target. First, Muhammad Ali's speed. Combination. Does he still have it? That was almost a lead right. Ali's attitude in this first round toward Norton is one of scorn.
Some of his best rounds have been the first. He likes to psych an opponent out in that first round by showing him what he can do.
Each of them listed at 6'3". Norton appears a little bit taller. Ali has an 80-inch reach. Norton, 79. Ali has not stopped dancing for a second. And Norton has continued to stalk him.
Less than a minute to go in the first round.
A good rally.
Norton bent a little, but he wasn't hurt.
He was covering up.
Look of anticipation in Ali's eyes.
This is the best I've seen Ali look since going back before the Joe Frazier fight, March 8, 1971.
Well, the flab is gone.
The speed has returned so far, a foot and hand.
Ten.
About 9 seconds left. The first round is over. Muhammad Ali did everything he said he would, but he did not seem to bother Ken Norton. Bud Ferrillo.
The second comeback of Muhammad Ali. He did everything he said he would do in that first round. He kept up on his toes. I think that twice he may have stung Ken Norton.
How did
We're
you
looking
score
into
round?
Ali's corner right now. I gave the round to Ali, 1-0. And this is another sight that you're looking at of Muhammad Ali's. He likes to stand in his corner, make his opponent know that he's not bothered at all.
Meanwhile, Angelo Dundee, great handler of Muhammad Ali, and Eddie Futch.
In the other corner,
Kenny
you
Norton.
Saw Eddie Futch talking animatedly to Ken Norton. And Ali is dancing into the shuffle.
A little shuffle. Remember in his locker room interview, we asked him, did he have on his dancing shoes? He has, as Don Ohlmeyer gets a tremendous shot for you.
Wide-eyed look in Ali's face.
Regardless of what happened, because of this tremendous conditioning program of Ali, he, in at least this reporter's opinion, looks 5 to 7 years younger than he did in his last fight.
There's no question about it. For a year now, or more than a year, you've seen the layer of fat around the midriff, and you don't see it tonight.
And you don't see any on 28-year-old Kenny Norton either. Ali with a waist of 33 and a half inches. Kenny Norton, a 32-inch waist.
You notice the much more powerful legs of Ali.
Look at the stalking of Norton. He hasn't stopped stalking, and Muhammad Ali hasn't stopped dancing.
Norton's strategy is that when Ali is doing nothing, then he intends to hit him with a real powerful jab.
Norton has not landed a punch yet. Bundini Brown in the corner, and he is the most avid supporter Muhammad Ali will ever have.
He's the cheerleader.
I actually saw him cry real tears after Joe Frazier won in Madison Square Garden. I would be misleading you if I said that either fighter had landed a telling blow. Norton on the move. So's Cassius Clay, Muhammad Ali of 1973.
And referee Dick Young has warned Bundini Brown to quiet down. He's going to throw him away from the ring. Have him ordered away.
Dick Young is without a peer as an official. He is a great one.
Best in the state.
Slap jab coming out there, thrown by Ali. Not hurting too much, but very bothersome. Good left hand by Norton. He actually picked him up by the hips and set him on the second rope. Norton picked him up.
That's something that Norton did in the first fight as well. Threw a block on him.
Ali 212, Norton 205.
The sweet jab he's got going.
closing in on the end of round six. Take it.
That's the end of round number two, and the crowd at the Fabulous Forum totally delighted.
Corner for the first time that there's really a good exchange by both fighters. Ali decided to stay in his ground and slug with Norton. Good left hook by Kenny Norton. Right by Ali. Picks off a left. And here you'll see Norton pick him up.
There it is.
All right, sit him down. There have been no knockdowns, but we have one sit down.
Give me your scoring.
I've got Ali 2-0 after two rounds.
Why did you give that round, just for the fans' sake? Why did you give it?
Well, there are four things that determine the scoring of round, as I mentioned before. Ring generalship, certainly Ali has that. Boxing, defense, and punching power. I think that in three of the categories, he excels. Power, I give to Norton.
I can just hear some of the fans booing that. All right, here we go. This, of course, has nothing to do with the official tally, ladies and gentlemen. Bud Perillo, boxing expert, giving you his personal scoring. Round three, we're scheduled for 12. If you joined us late, Muhammad Ali in the white trunks.
Norton, it's that widespread thing, the right foot line.
Right above us now. Both men starting to perspire profusely. Right hand, and it got through, despite the good defensive try by Norton.
He hasn't missed a punch this round. That left of the body made Ali wince.
Right on the belt buckle. And Norton has showed that he likes to go with that left hand here early in this fight. 2 minutes left in round three. A little chopping combination by Muhammad Ali, a sequence that made him famous.
Norton beginning to open up.
Oh, beautiful right-left combination by Kenny Norton. One of the things that I think I noticed about Ali, Bud, he's more able to elude punches and trouble because of his quicker.
That's right. He hasn't stopped dancing. Something on those jabs, I'll tell you.
Yes, and they're going to feel like heavyweight bombs a little bit later on if they keep getting through. A lead right hand by Muhammad Ali. They better be in condition, bud. Because they're moving. Less than a minute to go. Round three. Eddie Futch calling up to his man, Kenny Norton. Keep sticking.
It appears that Norton is trying to corner Ali and then really unload.
The question is, can Ali dance 12 rounds?
Well, he did it against Buckner. Of course, Buckner was not the puncher that Kenny Norton is.
And Buckner was not as quick a foot as his Norton. And I don't think he pursued quite as much.
Norton is certainly stepping up the pace.
Good left hand scored by Ali. A right uppercut by Ali. About 5 seconds left in the third round. The end of the third. Marvelous action for the fans. Muhammad Ali's corner goes to work at the back of Bundini Brown.
And Ali is standing up. Inside the ring with him. Referee Young over to talk to Ali about something.
Ali went for a walk away from his corner, 10, 12 feet away. We'll try to get a word from Dick Young as to what he said to Muhammad Ali.
That was referee Dick Young saying that he warned Ali to keep his left glove closed.
And as soon as he told Ali or made that admonition, Ali nodded in assent. Eddie Futch goes over now to referee Dick Young and says something, probably asking if that's what he told him. all the technicalities going to be brought to light and strictly enforced by the great ring arbiter, Dick Young.
There's Arthur Murray over there.
You got that one by me for a minute.
I really should have said Bojangles.
Muhammad Ali has been a pro 13 years. He won his title 4 years after turning pro. 1964. Oh, Norton ran into a left hook, and now he pushes Muhammad Ali away. Muhammad Ali ricochets off the ropes. Oh, is he fast on his feet tonight, and Norton is right after him.
Norton believes that he is the stronger of the two. There's no question of that.
Norton's got a 16-inch bicep. Ali a 15, if that means anything, and I doubt that it does.
And it's left. The old Ali.
Yes, it is. It certainly is. If Kenny Norton beats this Ali, Kenny Norton is going to get some great, great respect, even more than he has now. That was on the elbow of Muhammad Ali.
Put them together. Put them together.
In the corner, that's where Norton wanted him. And he gets his left hook coming out. That's what Norton's been trying to do. His strategy says get him in that corner and pound.
Norton do a dance.
Yeah, Norton did a bit of a shuffle of his own. About a minute left to go in round number four. That left jab again. Picked off that time by Norton, who slaps it away. The hook went over the head of Norton. Look out, right above us.
I count Norton landing only 3 punches so far this round.
Seconds left in the round as Ali scores. That left hook by Norton was just short of a retreating Ali's chin.
Best punch of the fight for Ken Norton, and he yelled at Ali.
Ali got him a split second after the bell. I don't think it infuriated Norton, however.
I say that Kenny Norton yelled at Ali after he hit Ali with that right hand.
Right.
I don't know what he yelled, but I'm sure that Kenny was pleased with himself.
I think he said, "Did you say ouch?"
And you will notice that Ali is sitting down now.
For the first time between rounds. Good observation. Chick Hearn along
with his
Bud
head, with his head down. That was one hell of a right hand.
If he is going to start tiring, it might show up in the middle rounds. We'll be going to round number 5.
And he's dancing again. Shuffling. Norton still seated.
If Ali is trying to psych Norton, I would say he has failed. Round 5, and what do you have the scoring?
I scored the last round even, mostly on the basis of that great right hand.
So you've got a 3-0 going.
3-0 Ali. We've got a different Ken Norton in there now, too. Notice the way he drags his right leg.
It's always been his style. Kenny was the All-Marine champion in 65, 66, 67. good drilling left hand scored by Norton.
There's
mid-section.
A different look on the face of Ali now.
Norton, who has worked so many times with Joe Frazier, is emulating Frazier to the extent of the stalk, trying to cut off the ring on Ali.
And scoring much more effectively with his jab now. He has reddened the nose of Ali.
Ali is not the same fighter in this round that he was in the first four rounds. Perhaps it's a coast round for him. Regroup.
120 left in the round.
Oh, chopping right hand. It glanced off the side of the head of Norton, but it was a scoring punch. Good uppercut by Norton. Right-left combination. Norton.
Norton coming on.
And Ali hangs on.
Ali landed his best punch of the fight in this round, a right hand. It didn't faze Norton.
After missing the hook with the left, Norton got the right home to the belly button.
Norton again concentrating right on the body, trying to bring those hands of Ali down.
Well, he's leading with that left hook up jaw high and then coming into the side of the rib. Good right hand by Ali. The left jab by Ali. And Norton ever pressing, always on top, this man. Ali gets him with a good left hook inside. A furious exchange. A left hand on the forehead of Ali. And the round is over. And Norton screams at him in derision. He got right to his ear and screamed, "I own you."
We're looking at Ken Norton. Eddie Futz working on him. He's a much more confident Ken Norton now.
After the way he talked,
body punches.
At the end of the round to Ali, there is no doubt in this reporter's mind that Norton thinks he's going to beat Ali.
Well, he's talked to him at the end of the last two rounds. Ali has abandoned the chair again. He's standing up in his corner. Here's the last flurry of the previous round. Butterfly trying to ward off Norton.
Here we go to round number six. Bud Ferrillo gave that round to Kenny Norton. Unofficially, his scoring is 3-1. Ali still in front. The halfway mark of this 12-rounder for the North American Heavyweight Championship, but a lot more at stake, particularly for Muhammad Ali.
He has said he might retire if he loses. What would boxing do without him?
That left hook got across the glove of Ali and hit Ali's jaw.
Norton's pressing more than he ever did, even in the early rounds of the fight. He just seems so sure of himself now.
Ali still on his toes, still dancing.
He knows Ali can't hurt him, and that's why he's moving in. Or at least he thinks he can't hurt him. There's the jab I spoke about. The powerful jab of Ken Norton. There it is again.
That turned the head backwards a little bit, Ali.
When Ali loafs, he's going to get hit with that jab. That's what Norton worked on so hard in training camp.
The uppercut by Ken Norton. The left hook sweeping by the chin of Ali.
Norton taking extreme chances. This doesn't seem at all worried about Ali's punch.
Minute and a half left in round six. I don't know why, but heavyweight champ of the world, George Foreman, is leaving.
Isn't that amazing? George can't stand for a fight to go over two rounds, I guess.
Norton got his man where he wants him, in that corner, on the ropes.
Left hook by Ali. Good punch. Yes, he hurt
Nardes again. He's hurt Norton. Let's see how Norton responds to this pressure now. He took a couple of solid shots. And he's in throwing his own leather.
Come back, George Foreman. You're missing a great fight.
Norton going to peekaboo a little bit more.
I think Kenny's hurt.
Ali is flicking shots out there now with both hands. He appears to have shortened up his punches just a little bit.
A mouse under the left eye of Ken Norton.
The best round of the fight for either fighter. A mouse has appeared under the eye of Kenny Norton. Let's take a look at some of the action.
You're going to see Ken Norton staggered here by Ali. There's the right hand. Made him dance. Ken Norton has the reactions of a man who may have had just one too many.
Said during some of our commentary, Bud, that the fifth round, the round before the last, might have been a coasting round for Muhammad Ali, and I sincerely think it was, and he came back awfully strong in the sixth.
And he smells it now. Kenny Norton, a very tough young man.
He's going to have to exhibit all his toughness.
Norton's eyes are clear.
All his grit. Right now, because Muhammad Ali has had his gas tank full of confidence, filled to overflowing with that last round. The mouse is under Norton's right eye, vulnerable to the left hook. It does not appear that there's even the remotest possibility at this time without further damage of that eye closing or coming close to it.
He's growing an egg under the right eye.
Uppercut by Norton, slashing right hand, left, another uppercut, straightens Ali up.
Ali's hurt.
Ali took the brunt of three or four of those punches. His legs were crossed on the ropes, and Ali is in trouble holding on. Kenny Norton with a furious exchange. A brilliant comeback from the previous 3 minutes. And now Ali with a combination left-right.
What a fight.
Two outstanding heavyweights. Both men have been hurt, and in this round. Chopping right hand, right on the jaw of Ali. And Ali felt that one to his ankle bone. Those two punches were picked off
if
by
ever
Ali's
the jaw arm. Was going to break again, that would have been the time.
Oh, he was wide open.
Bad.
And he's hurt. Ali hanging on. There's no possum. There's no cat and mouse. He's
20 seconds left in the round.
Trying to hang on the last 15 seconds of this round. hoping for round eight. 10 seconds left in a rousing seventh round. 3 seconds left. And Ali will go to the stool this time. Ali's used the stool only once before between rounds in this fight. He's on it now in a hurry. How'd you score that one? That was a tough one.
Ladies and gentlemen, I thought that was a two-point round for Ken Norton.
Based on what?
He had Ali in terrible shape. This man is amazing. I don't know what keeps him up. You know, early in his career, Ali would go down once in a while. Joe Frazier hit him with everything. The kitchen sink and only put him down once.
The crowd now starting the rhythmic chant.
They're for Norton.
I think they're yelling for Norton. Norton, a 5-2 underdog.
Now the Ali chant.
So for the sixth round, Ali gained confidence. Norton has regained his with a furious seventh round.
But Ali is still dancing.
Sitting here where we do at ringside, Bud Perillo, you can almost see a change of expression in their eyes, can't you?
Oh, yes. Ali is apprehensive now. Norton has the look of confidence.
Ali is not circling with near the rapidity that the first three or four rounds invoked. A digging left hand into the rib cage of Ali. A good left hook on the jaw of Norton. Another hook on the jaw of Norton. Ali put four hooks together there before you could call him. I may be wrong, Bud Perillo, but it appears that at times Ali's hands are coming down a little bit.
I think he's still moving very well, Chick, for the eighth round.
There is no doubt about that. I think it can be safely said both men are moving very well, considering the tempo of the fight.
The difference in Ali is that he has forgotten how to finish fighters. It looked like he could have finished Ken Norton in the sixth round. He let him off the hook.
Kenny Norton has knocked out 22 men in his 30 victories. Muhammad, of course, has had 31 knockouts in his 40 victories. Good combination left-right. Ali scoring. One minute left in round number eight. Our unofficial scoring, or Bud Perillo's of the Los Angeles Herald Examiner, has it 4-3 now. Ali still in front. Norton looked at the referee, Dick Young, as much as to say, make him quit pushing my head down.
The physical strain is showing, I think, on both fighters. They both look tired. And remember what Ali said. He said that Ken Norton may be too fine.
Oh, a left and a right. And that set Ali to the ropes. He got his guard down. Ali went high and then came right back head hunting with the right hand.
Can he take a punch?
Woo. Ali thought that the lightweight of 205 would detract from the skills of Norton. I don't believe it has, do you?
Very confident Ken Norton returns to his corner.
Well, what did you think of the scoring for that round, Mr. Perillo?
Ali pinned again, catches a terrible hook. Holds on. Right. This is Norton's strategy, to get him in those corners and then to punch him with both hands. And it's paying off.
Angelo Dundee with Muhammad Ali. How'd you score it?
The fight is all even on my card.
You gave that one to Norton, so it's 4-4. Unofficial, of course.
What a punch. Another one. Can he take it?
The scorecards will be officially signed by referee Dick Young and judges George Latka and John Thomas. Round 9.
Norton doing the jabbing now. Now we're going to see which man is really in the best shape. Condition could tell for the last four.
Another good combination left-right by Norton. Not as severe as the previous round, however. Ali has quit moving, at least temporarily. Oh, a slashing right hand. It sounded like almost an open glove by Norton. Kenny's attitude is that of an accountant going to work, auditing. Determined, conscientious, confident.
Ali's got to get out of those corners.
And Ali, hoping to get back some of the sap in those legs that carried him around so brilliantly in the first rounds.
Norton hit him low.
I did not see a warning, and I look for it from referee Dick Young.
Norton has no fear of Ali's punch now. He just wades in and punches whenever he feels like it. What a right to the midsection.
Norton hit him with a left jab. Drove it through the glove. Both men exchanged jabs.
Ali,
another Ali.
Right hand by Ali. It's Stagger Ken Norton.
Norton seems to be just a little bit wobbly-legged here.
Staggered him with the right hand.
We'll see. If Ali could get across another one right here, he might. 40 seconds left. The crowd is going absolutely berserk as these fine heavyweights unleash
their attack. Year. Look at them eye each other.
20 seconds left in round 9. Both men are apparently quite tired. 15 seconds. Ali having a scoring round. And now Norton scoring on his own. 5 seconds left. 2 seconds. 1. Wow. Kenny Norton definitely was wobbling a little bit as he walked back toward us and toward his corner. The crowd, regardless of their partisanship, highly emotional in that round.
Bowed, listening to Angelo Dundee. See both of them. Ken Norton on your left. Don't they look tired?
So we go to round number 10, and you scored that round for?
Ali.
He leads on our unofficial card 5-4.
And it's very unofficial.
Chick Hearn here at ringside along with Bud Perillo. Three grueling rounds, 9 minutes left, or will it be less?
Remember what Ali said, it can't go the distance.
And I remember what you said in our pre-fight chat. Ali to stop him in 10. Norton's style appears changed, as though he had taken on a new respect for Ali's punching power.
Look at the movement.
Starting to dance again.
He's been fighting for a half hour.
That was low. Right above us now. Older than Norton. Ali 31. Good left hand by Norton. Shoves Ali to the rope.
The old Ali wouldn't be trapped in a corner like this. The only other time it happened was against Joe Frazier. And I guess in the first Norton fight.
A minute left to go in round 10. Regardless of what happens in this fight, Norton has established himself as a real, real heavyweight contender. And Muhammad Ali, a brilliant fight. Fudge working over him.
Norton's best punch of the round right there. A round which I felt was pretty even.
So if you scored it even, we'll go to the 11th round of our 12-rounder with our unofficial card reading Ali 5-4. Dick Young, in case we should neglect it, and we should not, doing a masterful job as a third man in the ring. Split screen, and you get a good look at both trainers, Dundee and Futch, and both fighters, Norton and Ali. Round 11. Wow! Norton tried to end it right there. Norton got through that left jab. Ali missed and ran into a right hand hook. Looks like they both think they're about as close as... Oh, right in the breadbasket, and that hurt Ali. Norton going by.
Norton left to the knockout.
Norton hurt him in the breadbasket temporarily. But I'll tell you one thing, Ali, like Norton, is flat on the tummy. Two minutes to go in the round.
Kenny won't let him rest. Ali holding on. There he is in the corner again.
Is Norton too tired to take advantage of it? They're both very fatigued. Two hooks to the side of the head of Norton. Oh, Corner again. Where Norton's punches had some zip before. They're slow getting there, but that right hand uppercut hurt Ali. The left hook misses. That's picked off in the glove of Ali.
Ali's losing his pants. Pull him up.
A minute left to go in round number 11.
He may be losing more than that.
...45 seconds left in the round. Picked off in the glove. Woo! The roundhouse miss. ...20 seconds left in round 11. Seconds. Kenny got off balance, lunging at that combination. Ali did not land any yet. None of those punches landed.
Norton is dead tired.
The crowd thought they were landing. They were not landing.
He may have punched himself out there. He is awfully tired. And Eddie Futz is going to something secret here. Smelling salts, it looks like. Yes, sir. Got some smelling salts out of the box for him. And the way the round started, you thought that Norton was going to knock Ali out. Norton was all out at the beginning with tremendous body punches. Right there. Oh, that staggered Ali. You saw the wobble on his right leg.
How'd you score the round?
The fight is all even going into the 12th round on my card.
Bud Ferrillo gave it to Norton.
Who'll win it?
3 minutes of excruciating time for these two fine, well-conditioned performers. This round could win it for one or the other. A man's entire fistic future may be riding on this round.
And he's on his toes again. He's on his toes.
Norton, I believe.
Staggered Norton.
Remember, Joe Frazier says that's the place to go to the body. Ali with a beautiful combination. Ali coming on strong.
How about Ken Norton?
Fantastic display by both men. 2 minutes to go.
He's talking to Ali again.
A minute and 45 seconds to go. Minute and a half. We're right where we were when he started. Norton on the trail of Muhammad Ali.
He's back in the corner, but Norton's too tired now to punch back.
1:15 to go. 12th and final round. A very tough fight to judge. Very tough. 1 minute to go. Ali caught a left hand that hurt him. Another left that hurt him. Another left. 45 seconds to go.
Oh, right hand.
Beautiful right hand.
Turn Norton's face around.
Ali scoring. Norton driving him back again. Half a minute. ...20 seconds left in the fight.
Here comes Norton.
Ellie holding on.
10 seconds left.
It's going the distance.
And there is the bell. Kenny Norton. And Muhammad Ali. Thrilling a Los Angeles crowd.
I've got a feeling. I've got a feeling.
You got a feeling what?
I think that the comeback of Muhammad Ali has happened.
Whoever wins, whoever loses, both men.
I gave Ali the last round. I think that is the round that's going to win the fight for him.
Really gave it a shot.
There's a very tired Muhammad Ali. Worn out. Hitting Cosell on the head, just like he should. Get him.
He obviously is in a very good frame of mind.
You know, you were coming, man. After the guy picking up my card, you know. He looking at my card.
All right, Bud Ferrillo, I'm going up into the ring and talk to the winner, whomever it is.
And there is extreme doubt, Chick Hearn. Strange quiet has come over this fabulous forum. We wait for the decision here. Referee Dick Young. Announcer Jeff Timken has the cards. I guess we're ready for the decision. Here we go with the decision. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a split decision. Ringside scores it 6-5, Ali. Judge George Letka at ringside scores it 6-5, Kenny Norton. The deciding vote was cast by your referee, Dick Young. He sees it 7-5 to the winner. Split.
We've got the split decision. All right, we're with Muhammad here. Champ, a great fight. You haven't been in this kind of condition, I'm sure, for many years, and you had to be.
Right, I'm in good condition, but I'm tired than usual because of my age.
Forget your age. You were a spirited fighter, a game fighter. You took his best shot, and you came back with your own. And I'm sure that you feel that Ken Norton is truly a fine, fine boxer.
Not only that, he's a threat to the title. Well, I hold it. Who holds it? He's the next best in the world to myself.
That's a nice compliment. What are you going to do now, Muhammad?
First, I want to thank Almighty God, Allah, for the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, our spiritual leading teacher, whose teachings, by morals, and the proper diet enabled me to be ready for this fight. And also, we want to say hello to what's your own time, man.
And we want to say hello to Louis, the guy that gave us all the big rocks. And
also, Harvey Moyer. And Harvey Moyer, I'm building a training camp. I'm in condition because of my great training camp in Deer Lake, Pennsylvania.
Chick, I want to say hello to my wife and kids.
Good
to
see Harvey Moyer, and tell Harvey Moyer to hurry up and get my cabin built, because I'll soon be in training.
What's right. He going to do next?
Well, I guess he's going to take a little rest.
He deserves it.
We're going to go back and see our families for a change.
Good. Congratulations again. A great, great fight.
Thank you
like
very much.
Like I said, if I wasn't in that shape, there was no way I could have won.
No possible right. way. Right. Thank you. There you are, ladies and gentlemen. Angelo Dundee. And, of course, Muhammad Ali. Let me get over here now with Kenny Norton. K Kenny, could I have a word with Kenny, please, Eddie? Kenny, I can't let you get away without complimenting you on a brilliant, brilliant, brilliant effort.
Thank you very much, Jeff.
I just don't see how you could have fought any better. If anything, despite the loss, you've grown in stature tonight in the boxing world.
Thank you very much for the compliment.
Eddie, I know you're disappointed, but not in his performance.
No, I thought he performed exceptionally well against the well-conditioned, very sharp Ali.
Did he hurt you at any time?
I got hurt once in the 11th round by a good right hand.